Hello guys and girls, assalamu alaikum. My name is Muhammad Ali and today we are going to be covering user forms, finally. Okay, let's get started. I have my Visual Basic application in here. I can go to insert and you add a user form from here. Okay, just I can right click in here and insert a user form. So this is a user form tool. In here we have this called toolbox. We have something called user form itself and we have its properties. For example, properties are something like I want to change its name in here, so it's gonna say like data entry, so it's gonna appear in here. And like there are lots of options we'll cover this later. Maybe not, whatever. Okay, so that guy is gone. How can you bring it back? You can click in here, it's gonna appear. If it doesn't, you can just close. You can click in here, it's gonna appear. Okay, if you don't have this, you can just click on property. This is the properties window, or you can click F4 and it's gonna appear. Okay, and project, you can just click it in project window. Oh, this is properties, this is project window. Actually, I don't ever remember these things. Okay, how this works, it's gonna be like this. You can just enter data from here and it's gonna go there. Okay, so how you can enter data? You can enter data using this. You have a couple of things. You have so object selection means you can select objects in here. And you have this means a simple text like this. And I'm gonna say like in here it says first name. I'm gonna say last name. First name again. First name. And I can now if I this is selected, I can just drag it anywhere I want. Okay. And I can just and the second one is text box. Text box is something where you enter text. Let's look at how it looks. It looks like this. I can enter now like Yanshu. I don't know why I did this. I don't know. Okay. We have combo box, we have list box, we have checkbox, we have option button and lots of other things. And some which are not in here, but you can go to additional and find them. It's not gonna appear in me. I have a problem with that. I'm gonna show you how it works later, but for now let's just forget this. Okay. And we have something called command button. Command button is simply a button when you click it. Okay. How does it work? Well, basically, when you arrange all the things and you want a data to be entered in here, when is the data entered? When you click on something like click on submit, it's gonna say when you click on this, for example, when you click on, you want to do something like when you say yen, you want to click on this and it should go in here, right? Yeah, I think I'm right. So how can you do that? Well, it's easy. Yeah, by the way, you can just click once and change this guy's name, like submit, and it's gonna get submitted. So first of all, you need to add fields again, like first name again, second name and third name. Oh, sorry, favorite anime, and a lot, and that's all. And add a button. Well, I have prepared this thing for. So this is the thing we have. I have the button named add, and that's everything is same as we saw. So pause this video and make something like this. Okay, let's go back. Okay, after this, we're gonna say add some code in the button. And when I click the button, it should happen. So we need to put the code in the click. We need to put the code in the button. And the way to add put code is double click on something. So if I double click in here, I'm gonna get to the window on which the code should run. For example, I say message box. It's working. So it's gonna do something like, it's gonna say, it's working. Okay, whatever you tell this guy to do, it's gonna do. Okay, for now I want this guy to go in here and put our data. What I want to do is we have this. I'm gonna say that range a1 dot and xl down dot offset. By the way, if you don't know how this happens, go to the previous tutorial and you'll know. Offset, I'm gonna say 1 ratio 0 1 comma 0. I'm gonna say dot value should be equal to me means this user form. You can say user form, you can say just user form 1, user form 2, but I prefer to use me is better. So me dot text box 1. So we have text box 1, text box 2. The text box 1, text box 1 was first name, so we're gonna say dot value. So value in the first, so what I'm saying is the value in the first box, or the box for text box 1, should go in here. Let's check how it works, whether it works or not. I want to say yan. I'm gonna click on add. It's gonna add yan in here. Okay, I think this is working. And similarly, I'm gonna just copy this and this and this. So, well, I need to go one step down, okay, and one step to the right. So one step down in here, one step to the right. I want one step down and two steps to the right, okay? And the text box, this is text box 2, this is text box 3, and it's gonna just add the values. Go one step down. Don't go one step down. Oh, sorry, guys, I think this is wrong. It's not one step down, it's just 0 and 0. When we are down, we need just to go to right and right, right? So let's see. We can say like Sufyan Yusuf, and favorite anime would be Naruto. I'm gonna say add, and it's gonna add those values, okay? And you can just keep on adding, but you need another button to clear everything in here. That would be easy. You just need to go in here, add a button, change the button value, go to say clear and double click. Okay, so double click in here. I'm gonna say me dot text box text one dot value equals nothing, so it's gonna make it empty. Me dot text box value dot text box two dot value is gonna make it empty, and me dot t text box 3 dot value is gonna make it empty. Okay, you are bad boy. I'm gonna just say add. I need to add another data. I'm gonna say clear, and are you bad boy? You bad boy. Come on. I'm gonna say okay. Add. So it's been added. That's all. This is how simple it is to create some data entry. Okay, guys. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any question regarding this tutorial or other, make sure to put it in the comment box below, and make sure to share if you're on the social media, you're watching this on the social media, make sure to share it with, make sure to share this video, and if you're on YouTube, make sure to like, subscribe and comment, because this really helps me a lot. Thank you guys, and see you later. Thank you.